Ladies and gentlemen, this week the House will vote to direct its committees to start rooting out the regulatory burden that is keeping capital on the sidelines and ensuring that jobs are not being created in America. This is the House that will help create more jobs in America. The Speaker of the House.
Well, thanks, Jeff. Republicans are continuing to be focused on creating an environment that will get economic activity moving in America and help create jobs. And this week, we'll take several more steps in keeping our pledge to the American people. Today, we'll begin the discussions about job-killing regulations that are strangling employers all over the country and directing our committees to identify those regulations and to take further action. Tomorrow, we'll unveil our budget-cutting bill to fund the government from March the 4th through September 30th. Again, keeping our pledge to the American people that we will cut spending. All of this will help create an environment where we'll have more jobs in America. Next week, we expect the president to outline his budget. I'm concerned that it'll have too much spending, too much taxing, and too much borrowing. Those are the kind of activities that I think cause employers to sit on their hands and to protect their pocketbook because of the uncertainty that continues to be created by this administration.
Good morning. Republicans are focused on jobs and the economy like a laser. We have several priorities. One is to reduce unemployment. Two is to work to increase the competitiveness of America and our businesses. And three, it is to create an environment that fosters long-term economic growth. Today in conference, we talked about our plan to cut spending because that has provided a big inhibitor to investment in job growth. Tomorrow on the floor, we'll be talking about ways to reduce the uncertainty surrounding the regulatory environment in this country so our companies, our businesses can be more competitive. We're going to go to the White House today to speak to the president. These are the kind of issues that we're going to talk with him about that hopefully we can find some common ground so we can see jobs grow in this country again.
Thank you. As you heard from the speaker and the leader, the way we turn this economy back around is that we grow the economy and we cut government. If you just take a quick example that we've been in the majority for 4 weeks. When I look back to the 111th Congress, in the first 4 weeks in the Democratic majority, they added over $600 billion in new spending. This new majority has cut more than $600 billion in the first 4 weeks. So there is a fundamental shift by a new majority. The other idea is about creating jobs. And a lot of that deals with regulation. When you look at the Small Business Administration, they say small business, where 70% of all jobs are created, with those with employees under 20, that it costs more than $10,000 a year per employee. We need to have a fundamental change. As the leader said, when we go down to see the president, I'm very hopeful. You won't be there, teleprompters won't be there, but we have a really frank conversation on how we are going to create jobs and cut the spending in Washington.
Last week I met with a company who said the only way that they can comply with the regulations is to not operate. And I meet with many, many business owners who say that the federal government is taking the fun out of the challenge of starting a business and growing jobs. And last November, the American people said no to the failed economic policies that have actually brought us a record high unemployment since its record since the Great Depression. And these policies include like the health care bill, the cap and trade bill that narrowly lost. And yet now we see the administration is trying to implement cap and trade through regulations. That is not the right process, and it's also not the right policy. At a time when 28 million Americans would like to have full-time jobs, we don't need more cap-and-trade regulations. So today, the Energy and Power Subcommittee is going to be hearing a bill on the Energy Tax Prevention Act. It's to prevent the administration from moving forward on these job-killing regulations. And we support it, we're going to work to get it passed, and we're going to continue to promote the policies that actually put Americans back to work.
I was heartened to hear in the State of the Union the president making the connection between the regulatory burden and the lack of job creation. Unfortunately, he has placed much of that regulatory burden on the American people and on small business. 240 some odd regulations under the permanent bailout bill of Dodd-Frank. 6,000 plus pages of regulations so far under Obamacare, necessitating hundreds of waivers. Every single day, we see more of the regulatory burden keeping capital on the sidelines and preventing small business people from either creating a new enterprise or enlarging one to get the American people back to work. And this week, the House of Representatives is going to do something about it.
Question.
Mr. Speaker, and perhaps Mr. Cantor, you've all said that everything is on the table in terms of cuts. Will that include the Congressional Pension Fund? That roll call reports to this morning that at least $26 million taxpayers may be on the hook for, something you've been reluctant to do in the past.
The first order of this new Congress was to cut Congress's own budget. Our leadership budgets got cut, committee budgets got cut, and every single member's account got cut. We're going to continue to look at all ways to save money on behalf of the American people.
Mr. Cantor, could you address that, please?
Yeah, I agree with the Speaker's statement. And I would also say that you know, the people deserve a Congress that lives under the same laws that they do. And with bearing that in mind, we also believe that Congress and Washington should be living by the same reality that people do. And right now, it's about cutting spending. It's about making sure that you're not spending money you don't have, which is now bringing on the discussion that everything is on the table, that we have got to learn in Washington how to do more with less.
So it's not a sacred cow.
Mr. Speaker, yesterday you had your first loss as Speaker. Extensions of the Patriot Act went down under suspension. Were you surprised those went down? And specifically, there were eight freshman members that were nay votes who, had they voted yes, could have passed that bill. Does this foreshadow any problem you have with freshmen going forward?
Well, listen, we've been in a majority 4 weeks. We're not going to be perfect every day. And if the Democrats who voted for these same provisions last year would have voted for them this year, it would have passed. But we're going to get these extensions of the Patriot Act enacted because it's important to the safety and security of the American people.
Speaker, why was this under suspension, Mr. Speaker? Why was this, it didn't seem like you had the votes, obviously, went down. Why was this scheduled under suspension?
It was.
Mr. Cantor yesterday said that, that he welcomed deeper cuts next week when you have the debate over the CR. Do you support deeper cuts than the Appropriations Committee laid out? And if Republican leaders do want deeper cuts, why not propose them at the outset?
Listen, I've made it clear for months now that I believe that we ought to allow the House to work its will. I've been a big believer of this for the 20 years that I've been here. Now we have a chance to actually do it. And let's let the House make that decision. It's not about my decision. It's not about anybody else's decision. All members, Democrats and Republicans, ought to have the chance to involve themselves in the process of legislating and let all members represent all Americans to develop how much cutting do the American people really want. And so I'm looking forward to the debate. I'll look at the amendments, and let's let the House decide. Thanks.